Hello everyone, and welcome back to Fallout 4. So I took the time between episodes just to clear out our scrap, just to make sure that we have all the steel we need. It looks like we're okay so far. We also got attacked by Forge, because of course the Forge are still a thing. I guess they'd be in the Ironworks, but I mean, it says cleared, so I don't know why there would still be Forge there. We're going to head in that general direction anyway. Not Finch Farm. We are going to be heading down to the railroad and setting up MILA. Not necessarily in that order. Just follow the road, I guess. That should lead us pretty much where we want to go. It's been a long time since we've been down this road, so should be in that general direction. Good to know. Okay, just some random settler just wandering about, I guess. So one thing I did learn about settlements is that you notice in most of my settlements I have people doing scrap work, and that's a good way to fight unemployment. Fighting unemployment's a good way to increase happiness. You increase happiness, more people are likely to move in, and that's why most of my settlements have like 20 odd people in them. But the scrap works like this. So every day, every in-game day, obviously, you have people will drop in one item of scrap per person you have doing scrap. Up to a limit, though. I think the limit's like 100 items or something like that. And the items are like fuses or biometric scanners or things that you then need to go back to and then scrap. So it helps. It means you don't have to do all the scrap searching yourself, but it also means that you're not just able to just sit back and let it roll in, you know? Because the stuff that... Boy, this guy's annoying. He's almost there. There we go. Also, the stinging just randomly, huh? Okay, sure. But it doesn't mean you need to go back to each one of your settlements periodically and scrap things. And we took a little bit of damage there, but not too bad. I kind of wish it made it so that they would just generate like a random piece of like finished scrap. But I guess that wouldn't actually provide as much benefit. Take no prisoners, she said. Oh, it's a Brotherhood Knight. Okay. Well, much as I hate them, we're not going to actually do anything about it. You are legendary. Take out your eye. I don't know if that would actually, like, disable you, but maybe. Oh, of course, you mutated. Well, now we have lots of health. Assuming, of course, the vertebrate doesn't just drop out of the sky like they're prone to do. Alright, we're gonna have to take... Oh, there we go. And then he's out. Okay, good. The vertebrate actually landed. I don't think I've ever seen them properly land before. Ah, that's not true. I've seen them land before. It's just... It's funnier to say I haven't. Oh, what the hell? What the actual hell was that? Oh, did it blow up? Is that what it was? Okay, Ghoul Slayer's 10mm pistol. Big freaking deal. Okay, some good stuff. Are we still fighting more guys here? Oh, yeah, there we go. Well, Brotherhood of Steel are here in force. So, you know, we just leave them to it, I guess. What are you guys fighting? As long as you're not fighting my settlement, we're good. Oh, no, it's a Forged. Of course it is. Well, you guys don't know flanking maneuvers? I mean, you can overwhelm them with fire. Sure, that works too, but... Anyway, let's just keep going. There is... Why do I have a waypoint off to the east? Oh, that's just probably so I knew where the lighthouse was. Okay. That was like 2 episodes ago. Alright, let's keep going south. Follow the road. Yellow bricked or not. Roger Wilco will catch up to us, so we're fine. But yeah, so visiting the settlements are something you need to do periodically. Actually, I'm kind of glad it isn't one piece of, like, refined scrap. Like, just steel or cork or something you actually use directly. Because then if there was a limit, you wouldn't be able to fight against that limit. I mean, you'd constantly have to build things in order to fight against the limit. At least this way, they made it so that you'd have, like, an infinite amount of scrap, technically speaking, but they could still generate more for you. Yeah, okay, so it makes sense. It's just, I also wish there was a way you could automatically break down the scrap. I don't know how they'd do that exactly. There should be some way to do it, though. Or make it so that there's a certain kind of scrap station. Yeah, actually, that would work out really well. Make so there's a certain kind of workshop you can assign one of the settlers to that breaks down any of the stuff into its basic components. That'd be fantastic. Because then I could drop off my stuff. Oh, like this poor guy here. Okay, looks like they just took care of one of the provisioners. That's bad. National Guard training facility. Have we done this before? Didn't wake anybody up. Yeah, wasn't this full of ghouls or something? Am I making that up? Have we cleared this out? We have not. National Guard training guard is still a thing. Yeah, because I remember there being ghouls inside this bus, right? Oh, hello. I probably shouldn't have gone inside. Is there one behind me? There might not be. Feral ghoul roamer. Well, there is one behind me in a different way. Okay, take out you, take out you. And it worked, and we got our AP back. And there's two more on the way. Somewhere. I don't know where. We're not being stealthy, so they should walk right up to us. They might be inside this building. Yeah, there they are. Am I gonna be able to hit through the window? Oh yeah, that worked. Sometimes it doesn't, so you never know. He's firing at something. Oh, there's another machine gun turret, of course. That missed? Oh no, there we go, okay. It just took so long for the shot to get there. It is in super slow motion, to be expected. You know, I'd love to clear this place out. Don't get me wrong, but I think instead we're just gonna keep heading towards the waypoint. Because I kind of remember this, and it was a pain in the ass to get everywhere, if I remember correctly. Yeah, see, I opened this door before. I remember doing that. I remember doing all of this. So, it's kind of annoying that it all regenerated. I don't want to repeat a last episode where basically all I did was go around a previously explored area and then not be able to clear it out, which is a risk. Definitely a risk, and we are more powerful now. But it also seems likely that, or seems possible anyway, or probable, probably more accurate, that we're just not going to be able to clear it out for who knows what reason. I mean, I still don't know why we couldn't clear out the Dunwich Borer's quarry. No idea where that quarry key went, or where it goes. I'm guessing that maybe it'll be like a, oh man, there's so many guys just all over the place. There's a bloatfly there. Was that a provisioner that we just saw disappear? There is a provisioner there, or at least one of his Brahmin. And there she is. She has a minigun. Way to go! That's the way you defend yourself. That's awesome. Good to see the provisioners are taking care of business. Wouldn't it be great if you could assign settlers a bunch of different equipment? Can you actually do that? I don't think so. It'd be nice, though, because then all these plasma laser weapons we find, we could mod the hell out of them so they do max amount of damage, and then hand them to all the settlers. I mean, right now, the settlers just have pipe rifles. But if you could, like, load them up with, I don't know, night vision scopes and sniper rifles all up the wazoo, that'd be fantastic. Rain hell on anybody who dares approach your settlements. That'd be great. I would be for that. There might even be a mod for it. I try not to look at the mods too much, because then I get a little jealous of not being able to, well, I mean, I could put it in my game, but I don't want to. And I do want to, but I also want to do it vanilla first, more or less. Oh, you a guy that I need to worry about? Yeah, you are. I'll tell you what. How about if we crouch? Then we get 2x bonus. That might just straight up kill her. Plus the crit. Oh, there we go. She didn't even get a chance to mutate. Just vaporized. Okay, let's see what she had on her. Chances are it was junk. Well, Roger Wilco's cheerful, so that pretty much indicates that's it, right? No other raiders? She was by herself? It's weird. Oh, that's pretty junk. And we'll take everything because she's goo and who cares. Okay, so the Mila... Mila's around here somewhere. Where's the Mila at? Oh, I still have to cross the river. Okay. Should be a bridge to the south. There's just some inland lake, I guess. Okay, so we'll take that bridge across. Guess I got distracted. Well, good. Us stomping around should actually draw out any raiders if they're around. Which is a good thing, I swear. Mostly from my experience more than anything else. That looks like a path that goes up that way. I thought I heard somebody, but maybe not. This fog is driving my eyes crazy, though. Somebody over there? Bat says nothing. Okay, we'll just keep going. We're still not across, right? No, we need to go, like, far over to the west before we'll see a proper bridge. And that's assuming that isn't just, that's a missile launcher. That's weird, as I've been sitting here, like, for who knows how long until I notice it. It's hard to tell if that's actually, like, a working bridge, or if it's just remnant on the map from when the highway used to cross. Yeah, that's what it's looking like. Alright, is there another bridge? There might be. Oh, no, there's a bridge right there. Okay. Works for me. I also don't see anybody. This is prime Mirelurk territory, though. So might as well reload, because it usually takes at least two shots to take out a Mirelurk unless we hit him in the face. But maybe no Mirelurks. Okay. No raiders either. Just that one legendary raider just standing by herself. That was very strange. Okay, there's a lookout. Oh, we found the Silver Shroud radio signal. Yeah, I'm tempted to do it. It bugged out on us as soon as we loaded up Far Harbor, and I regret that. Because I was having fun with that, and apparently Shianti was too, because the voice she put on was just absurd. Okay, so we should have the Mila, like, immediately to our left. I'm guessing it's going to be on top of the highway, right? It's got to be it. Yeah, so we should try it just to see if we can finish it off. That'll be fun. If we can't, though, we move on. Unidentified intruder detected. Okay, well, we found a robot who really doesn't like us. Sounds like a Protectron. There's a door here. Mean pastries. Okay. Scanning for hostiles. That's a hell of an alleyway. Okay, he says that area is secure, so he doesn't see us. Alright, well, I don't know how to get up here, but it's definitely, like, in this building. Or probably, like, it's probably more likely going to be right on top of the highway. There is a way to get up there, but I don't remember what it is. So why don't we just go ahead and go inside Mean Pastries, and if that leads us up, great. If it doesn't, well, then it doesn't. But at least that way we can clear out one place. Maybe pick up some junk. Junk's always good. It's also kind of funny to me how the radio signals don't permeate through walls very well. I mean, as soon as we stepped inside the building, we lost the signal. Sure, we'll take the bread box. What the heck? I mean, I guess we should go behind the counter. Get the bucket. Okay, Roger Wilco is with us. Sure, cake bands, why not? It's been a long time since I made cake. Mostly because, I mean, my mom was really good about making cake, but then again, she had a family to feed, you know? And if you're gonna feed a giant family, you might as well, you know, load them up on sugar as much as possible. I mean, it's empty calories, but at least it's calories and it gets people fed, you know? I totally understand that. It totally makes sense. And that's it. That's it for Mean Pastries. All right. Well, that was weird and interesting. Yeah, then we gotta go out the north end. Alright, so that didn't lead up at all. But yeah, I don't make cake because, you know, I don't. I mean, I live with my girlfriend. That's it. We could probably give it to other people, but it always seems weird to me to show up at a place with cake. And I know people would love it. They'd say, yeah, go ahead, bring that cake on over. It just seems weird to, I don't know. It almost feels like trying to bribe friendship, and that's totally not what it is. I mean, it's just making cake because I feel like making a cake. But, you know, when we make cookies, I mean, it's probably the equivalent amount of sugar and flour and, you know, whatnot to make the cookies. And, I mean, we'll keep those in the house forever. Well, not forever. I mean, they're gone in, like, a month. But we're talking about, like, 4 dozen cookies in a batch. And I know you could really shrink down the batches and make it so that they're only, like, 2 dozen cookies and be fine. But for some reason, I guess it's because I lived with, well, my parents before, and that's when I used to cook a lot. And my dad is like me, he has a sweet tooth. So, you know, of course, you know, we make 2 dozen cookies, they're done in like 2 weeks. If that, if they don't get just immediately gone in like a week. My girlfriend and I mean, I try to keep my sweet tooth under control. And my girlfriend's really good about keeping her sweet tooth under control to the point where I'm envious. But like, she will keep a jar of jelly beans just around and won't touch it for like months at a time. Oh, I'm not quite able to make it up there. Okay. And take like one jelly bean every, I don't know, week or so. One jelly bean, maybe 2 jelly beans. And to me, that's like, man, I will sit down and like eat like an entire bag of jelly beans in like 2 days, maybe 2 days. If I really am feeling it though, I will totally eat that bag of jelly beans in like the same day and like the same sitting. Ah, that took care of her. Oh, no, it didn't. I thought you were dead. Oh, freaking piping. There we go. That one went through the piping just fine. I don't know what the criteria is for that. There must be a hitbox I'm just not seeing. Okay, how the heck do we get up here? I'm really thinking it is up here. Okay, maybe we take care of the raiders first. Now, if what I remember, Haymarket Mall doesn't have an upstairs entrance. From what I remember. I could be wrong. I guess we go inside and see. I guess what we could do is take the fire escape. That seems like the fastest way to get up there. And maybe we'll be able to jump like rooftop to rooftop or something. I don't know. I do like jumping with the jump jets. We have tons of okay, nothing over there. Oh, the stairs are over here. We have tons of fusion cores. So I shouldn't feel too bad about using them. Right, says the MILA is that general direction. Yeah, man, it's gotta be, like, up top or something. Alright, let's keep going up. We can, so we might as well. Up, up, do, 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 do. That's a big gap in the middle of nowhere for nothing. We have jump jets. So we made that work. Madruboko's gonna have... What the heck? There was another hole? There wasn't, though. What did I... I don't know what I slipped through here. Excuse me? Am I missing something here? Hold on, I know that didn't work. I don't actually need to go all the way around. I can just jump up here. And there we go. Okay. So, okay, let's pick up this stuff, right? Turpentine, paintbrush, blowtorch, all good things. Oh, yeah, there's a hole right there. Okay, I just didn't see it before. Okay, is there another hole? Just keep your eye on the grounds here. Okay, that might... I don't know if that leads up. We could try it. We go inside the train, we go up that way. Or we go up further this way, but I think that only goes to the top of the building. Alright, let's try this. We've never been in this before. Could work. I mean, we might as well go over here and see what we can get. Sure, loungewear. Why the hell not? Greaser jacket and jeans sounds cool. Alright, well, this is pretty much my nightmare scenario here. Oh, there we go. There's a Chevron. It's like subway attendant mode. Oh man, come on, really? There we go. Okay, and he wants the Mila in here. Okay. Fine by me. Done and done. Alright, so now we can go to Railroad HQ. We need to tell them about the Far Harbor place anyway, so it's fine. I thought this would be a way out. It is not. Well, you know what? I'm wearing power armor, so... Tally-ho! Thud. Alright. That was fun. I kind of want to do that again, but I suppose we don't. There's no real reason to. But that was a lot of fun. I mean, I realized I used the jump jets to get some really good height there, so I could use the full tally-ho. But it was still a lot of fun. I highly recommend it. Get your power armor today. Okay, here we go. That's right. That's right. It's been a while since we've actually walked here. We usually teleport. And usually takes us right inside the Old North Church. It should really take us through the back entrance, but I guess that's not really an entrance. That's an exit. Alright, so let's put our gun away because, you know, these guys are our friends. Let's not spook them. And then we'll just charge in through here. And of course we're going to get out of our armor to talk to him. What do you think? Of course it's going to happen. Just how we roll. It's always such a long trek back in here. I guess it's not that terribly long. It's just you really have to know your way around. And I keep forgetting my way around. Okay, well at least the door is always open. I mean, it probably really shouldn't be. But it is. Actually, shouldn't the teleportation point be, like, right inside here? Maybe it is. And I'm just forgetting. It has been a little while since we've talked to these people. Oh, he's got a message.
Randolph's safe house has got another dead drop for you.
Well, that's just, like, a filler mission, which is fine. Well, I mean, they keep numbering them, so maybe it's not a filler mission. Maybe if we do, like, X number of them, there's something that'll happen? I have no idea. Okay, so let's talk to Tinker Tom about his Mila. He's probably got yet another Mila for us. Hey, Glory.
The world's a dangerous place for anyone in my way.
Damn right,
Glory.
Glad
you're with us. Hey, you keep placing Milas, and I'll keep paying you.
That's
gotta
the plan.
Gotta on another vantage spot, if you got the time.
Of course you do. I knew you had one.
Or we could just do some business.
I don't think I have... Oh, we can talk
about
it.
Let's see what you got.
If he has any electromagnetic... 15. It's not too many, but I'll take it. And then... Oh, this is the stuff I sold him. Oh, no. This is actually stuff he has on his own. Never mind. Do I want any of this? I don't think I do. I mean, fusion cores, sure. Why not? Buy two of those. Hey, he has gamma rounds. We can at least play with that. I guess the plasma cartridges too, because we can always use some more. I'm not wild about any of these shipments. Okay, so then we can just go ahead and sell them most of our ammunition. We don't need. Let's see what else. I mean, we might as well. I mean, I took this stuff to scrap, but let's just sell it. Bayonet. Why would you put a bayonet on a freaking missile launcher? At least it's in the... Well, is it in the front? That is totally in the front. That's just weird. A bayonet on a missile launcher. You did that in the military. They would... Well, they'd probably send you in for psychiatric evaluation, probably, be my guess. What are you in for? Well, I put a bayonet on a missile launcher. Dude, you crazy! Get away from me! You're nuts! I want nothing to do with you. Which would be totally fair, by the way. Yeah, you know what? I don't need any missiles or a missile launcher. I don't even know why I was carrying it. I probably should have handed most of this stuff to Roger Wilco, but whatever. We're selling it now, which is fine. No, I'm not going to sell the steel. I need the steel. I realize most of this stuff breaks down into steel, like that. But nevertheless... I just want to get rid of most of it because I don't like carrying it around, and it gives us money. Oh, he doesn't actually have 727. Well, then I'll just take some of your other stuff then. How about your junk? I will take one of the shipments. I will take circuitry. Sure, why not? And then I owe you 57. All right, fine. All right, good enough.
Worth a fair amount.
Okay, so then balls. Let's talk to, you got too many teeth to be her.
Hey there. You're Whisper, aren't you? I've been looking for you. Name's Boxer. Boss called me in on account of some rumors making their way through the Commonwealth. Heard word that you've been up north. Maybe run into some sense that way. Did I hear correctly?
Oh, this is how we send them all up. Okay, I gotcha.
You heard right. I found a place called Acadia. Full of sense.
I knew it. There was always talk of some place up north, but we couldn't ever verify it. Do they need our help? Can we establish some formal communications with them?
Help isn't exactly right. But I guess so, sure.
They could absolutely use the railroad's help.
That's maybe the best news I've heard in a long time. Look, I'll head up north as soon as I can. If we can talk face to face with these synths, it's a good start. Thanks, Whisper. This could make a huge difference for us.
Okay, so now they know. I don't think we get anything special from that. Let's talk to Pam. Turn in her quest.
Some of the people you meet will be Institute replacements. Synth duplicates, so be careful what you say.
Systems locked. Building statistical model for Operation Tea Party.
Operation Tea Party?
That courser won't be bothering anyone again.
Mission's outcome correctly predicted. Warning. Odds of more coursers being discovered are extremely high. Reward for service delivered.
Okay, thank you. But you don't have anything else for me?
I secured the DIA cache for you.
Human interface. Well done, agent. Runners will be sent to acquire contents. Reward dispensed.
I totally forgot about that. That was like, what, 15, 20 episodes ago? Yeah, ruined skyscraper. That was a while ago.
Pam.
Recalibrating.
So does she have anything else for us? I guess not. Okay. Good for me then, I guess. Okay, so that's Glory. We can talk to Deacon and get him in here, but I don't really want him as a companion because he'll just talk and talk and talk. So that's it then, right? Yeah, we can do the safe trials, I guess. But I guess we're almost done. So let's go to Diamond City, talk to Ellie. And I mean, I guess on our way, we can go to Good Spring, or Good Neighbor. I keep calling it Good Springs. Why do I do that?
Word is Diamond City is under opposition control.
Well, that's not true anymore, man. Institute lost their hold when the mayor turns out to be a synth and was revealed to be a synth, so he's out. He's been vaporized. I think, actually, did we vaporize him? I know we had to attack him, like, twice because I'm bad. But I thought... don't remember if we actually gooified him with the pistol or if Ada got a good shot on him and vaporized him or if we just managed to just mow him down with sheer firepower. It was one of those. Okay, so, yeah, we're gonna try... we're going to try to do Good Springs again. I suppose what I should do is leave my armor out because I can't do it in armor, I think. At least I need to be wearing the Silver Shroud armor. I would love to be able to drop this stuff off finally. The only way we're doing that is if we finish these missions.
Terminal somewhere.
So we got to, yeah, so maybe leave the power armor outside Good Neighbor, take out the fusion core just so no one else walks away with it unless they have their own fusion cores, which they're amazingly prevalent in the Commonwealth, so that's not entirely unexpected. But anyway, we put on the Silver Shroud armor, we go inside Good Neighbor, and then we see what happens. I mean, we might as well stop in and pick up some EC ammo if we find it, because the more we can use the Gauss rifle, I think the better off we're going to be. Gauss rifle, I think, is our most powerful weapon. The plasma gun does some good damage, but I'm pretty sure Gauss rifle is more powerful. One thing we haven't done in terms of perks is loaded up the explosives perk, so explosives do more damage. If we did that, explosives might be a little bit more viable as an alternative. I mean, our frag grenades are basically doing crap damage right now. They're doing okay against little guys, like raiders or something, but they're not doing very good against synths or anything. Now, granted, frag grenades are the lowest tier, so that is something to consider. This is leading us over to Ellie, right? Yes, okay. We might as well take out our guns, because we should be seeing lots of bad guys, I expect. It's the only reason why I'm not fast traveling, is so that we can see lots of bad guys. But good neighbors should also be on our map here somewhere. Old Corner Bookstore. Garden Terrace. Thought it was in here. Yeah, there's Good Neighbor. Okay, so let's place a marker on Good Neighbor. Head there first. Probably not through the building, but let's go this way. Make sure we don't get ambushed. Also, this probably won't be the most direct route. We'll probably have to circle around, because there's only one entrance to Good Neighbor. There is one way in through, like, the rooftops, but that's not actually an official way in. Yeah, actually, I think that's it right there. Okay, we don't actually need to turn around. Oh, I just got bitten or something? Yeah. Vicious mongrel tried to bite my toes off. Okay, is there another one? Nope. Okay, just a vicious mongrel all by himself. Alright, so where are we going to leave the armor at? Probably someplace obvious, otherwise I will totally miss it. So how about, like, right here in the path? Like, right outside Good Neighbor? Impossible to miss, right?
No sign of him now.
Scare the bejesus out of anyone who's who's trying to bring harm to Good Neighbor. They've been good to us. Okay, so pop out here. Should be pretty obvious, and then we'll take the fusion core out. Okay, I must have sold off the other ones. So just have to make sure that I know to do that. Oh, okay, we have to put on the silver shroud. Yeah, so activate that. Come over here to apparel and put this on, and hopefully this works. Yep, we're now the silver shroud. Okay. All right. Hopefully, cross your fingers, ladies and gentlemen. If it doesn't work, no big. I guess we'll talk to Ellie, and then we'll start the nuclear option, because I don't know what else to do. Okay, so now we turn on the radio. Silver Shroud Radio.
Alexei! News!
Oh, and we can level up, too.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, The Mechanist Unmasked.
Peace, sister.
Dangling over a pit of fire reminds me of our adventure against the Chelsea Mingler, mistress.
Indeed, stalwart Shroud. But that malformed murderer was but a muppet compared to the malignancy of the mechanist.
Malignant?
Nope, nope, nope. The alliteration's too much. I can't handle it. So that's not it. It's not working. I don't know why we went to the proper location. We listened to the radio station. It wasn't interrupted so that we could hear anything else, so I think it's bugged out. I could probably find the code to reactivate it. It might mean going back a step or something, but I don't know. It's not worth it. I mean, I'm already not getting... Yeah, I guess I could do it. Okay, you know what? Let's talk to Ellie first. Yeah, let's go get our power armor. I might as well move back into out of costume. That's the fedora covert sweater vest. That's just... For some reason, that's really disturbing. I don't know why. It just looks wrong to me. I mean, it's pre-war. Maybe that's what it is, but this actually looks far better, doesn't it? I don't know, man. Maybe it's just something about sweater vests. I have no idea. It just, it looked very, very strange to me. Seeing Chianti in a sweater vest. Okay, so, yeah, Silver Shroud's out. That's too bad. It was an interesting quest line. It means we're going to be carrying this armor around forever, but we're only carrying, like, less than 100 pounds of stuff, and we can carry, I think, 400-something when we're in power armor, so, like, 1/4 of our current weight is taken up by weapons, armor, and, well, a little bit of plot armor, like, plot relevant. That's totally fine. We'll deal with it. That's how it goes. Okay, so just pop in this fusion core here. Okay, and then we're good to go. And let's go ahead and march over to Ellie and tell her that Far Harbor is done. We tackle any raiders on the way. Fantastic. We did also, by the way, see a level up marker, so we might as well do that. Medic is an interesting idea. I'm kind of tempted by it. But I think instead what I'm going to do is there should be a perk here for energy resistance. Chem resistance. And the reason to do that is because we're about to attack the Institute. The Institute does nothing but Institute rifles, which are all laser weapons. So if we can find... Okay, rad resistance. I thought it was in here. Oh, here we go. Refractor. Plus 10 energy resistance. Not much, but at least it helps. And so what's the next version of that perk? Next rank. Plus 20, plus 30, 40, 50. Wow, plus 50 energy resistance would be fantastic, but that'd take a long time to get there. And I don't think we're going to do it. I'd be really surprised. We'd have to basically go to each one of our settlements, deconstruct and reconstruct everything. That would basically do it. Maybe visit every point in the Commonwealth and kill every bad guy, and we might get 5 more levels, but I don't think it's gonna happen. Oh, critted him. Okay, what is he gonna have on him? I doubt it's gonna have much. Kneecap or machete? Oh, why do you give me the horrible things? Okay, there's apparently a bunch of super mutants in there, but I don't care. I mean, I guess if we get a little bit more energy resistance, that'd be great. So maybe I do care. Maybe I do want to take these guys out. Maybe I do want to make the Commonwealth a better place for everyone. Maybe I am totally stuck. No, I'm not. Okay, good. Good, I'm not stuck. So yeah, sure, we'll charge in here. We'll take care of all these guys. Hello. Thank you for stopping your fire when I came into your line of sight. That's much appreciated. Probably the rest of you guys are up here, right? A nice thing about being in power armor is we don't have to take the stairs back down. Oh, I think, yep. I tried to rescue him, but no, we didn't actually need rescuing. We open this door? That is totally a door, and we can totally open it. Maybe. Almost. Nope, other way. There we go.
Got it.
I'm just standing in the way there. But I can take more hits than... Well, maybe Roger Wilco can take some pretty good hits. I did make him lots of armor. Okay, I'm not... Well... No, because... My contention here is that... Or my dilemma... is that the marine armor is nice. It works, it's functional. What it does not have is any extras. There's nothing really special about it aside from the fact that it's decent armor. I don't see any of the other bad guys, so I guess we're done. Okay, might as well leave out the door that we opened before and head to Diamond City. I thought I heard a droid, but I could be making that up. Yeah, I mean, the marine armor, and the nice thing is, it's a complete set. And I have the same problem in any RPG, really, is that if I find a complete set that looks nice, I want to keep that rather than actually use something that's better for me. I know that's silly, If it's better for me, why do I care what it looks like? I don't know. It's just aesthetics. I mean, there's a reason why World of Warcraft gives you dyes, is that they know you want all your stuff to be at least the same color, even if it looks like you found all your stuff in a thrift shop. Which is my main problem with World of Warcraft, EverQuest, RuneScape? Is that the other one? I don't remember. Anarchy Online was a little better about that. Wow. One superhero what game stuff? I really miss is, or MMO, is the superhero one with City of Heroes. That's what it was. Really like City of Heroes. There's Champions Online, but it's just not the same. Champions Online is a little bit too twitchy for me. This guy with the missile launcher. If, he's gonna get distracted. Oh, you're gonna really do this? Really? You're gonna fire point blank when you're within range? Well, it didn't hurt my leg, surprisingly. I don't know how the heck it didn't. I'm not taking the puncturing board. I'm sorry. I have limits, and you've exceeded them. All right. Well, at least we took care of him. There's another guy over here, right? Oh, it's a statue, isn't it? I am fooled by this statue every freaking time. But I always hit vats. I don't open fire. I hit vats to try to find something first. Oh, there's a Raider Scaver. We're way past their point right now, so I don't think they're going to see us. They're probably like upstairs or something. Don't even care. I mean, I know they're experienced, and I do want to do it, but I also don't want to do it. I don't know, man. I'm conflicted. I don't want to rush things down, but on the other hand, we're done. I mean, we're practically done. We talked to Ellie. That turns into the Far Harbor DLC. Pretty much makes that over and done with. Which means the DLC's done. We have a couple of miscellaneous quests. Just general housekeeping stuff. Talk to certain people here and there. This is a weird location. What is this? Okay, just randomness. Okay. The proper entrance to Diamond City, I think, is just around... Yeah, here we go. But yeah, we have very little in the way of actual quests. I suppose what we could do... What? ...is actually talk to the Brotherhood of Steel.
Let's do this.
Oh, what the hell? I jumped instead of hitting bats. That's hilarious. Talk to the Brotherhood of Steel, but... The Brotherhood of Steel are not nice people. And chances are talking to them will make us go through a long quest line of, you know, trying to earn their trust and, you know, helping them out. And I don't want to help them out. I don't want to earn their trust. I don't want anything to do with them. I want them to stay far, far away. And I'm pretty sure... Oh, you know what? Didn't we fail that mission before? We failed it by killing somebody, and I forget who it was. I don't remember. Survival difficulty is not for us, by the way, because I'm bad. So we're not doing that. Ellie should be down here pretty soon. And Nick is in Sanctuary, right? I don't know. Nick seems to teleport between here and Sanctuary pretty much at whim.
You that trader up from Quincy? You selling any ointment? I got me this itch.
Dude, I don't have any ointment, and you need to go see a doctor. Hello, resident. There is another mod, of course, that names all the settlers. I think it's called Don't Call Me Settler. We're going to go ahead and leave. Well, no, we're not going to leave the armor out. We'll just talk to Ellie, tell her it's done. That's it. I keep passing the door. It's over here. There we go. I'm guessing Nick is in here. He's not, actually. That's kind of a surprise. Okay.
You're back. How did everything go with the Nakano case?
Let's just say the case is closed. Leave it at that.
That bad, huh? All right. I'll just mark this down as closed and throw it in my Better Left Forgotten About folder. Thanks for coming in for this one. I knew something good was happening when you and Nick started working together. Don't be a stranger, Gumshoe.
All right. All done. Not necessarily to Ellie's satisfaction, but I don't think anybody cares about that. Hold up. Hold up. Hold up. Are you telling me this is supposed to be the alleyway we came in through? I can't even look at this. There's no way. There's no way. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. It can't be. I mean, I know they just wanted to wait it. I guess this is where Ellie sleeps. Though there's a second bed here. Does Nick actually sleep? I mean, you wouldn't think he'd need to, but... Okay. Anyway. It's funny I never saw that part before. Alright, so let's start the nuclear option, I guess. I think that's talking to Sturges, which is up in Sanctuary, so I guess we better get marching. Is there anything else we need to do in this general area? There's a safe house, which I suppose we could do. Server Shroud doesn't work. I don't even know who. Oh, McReady. Yeah, wasn't there somebody in Good Neighbor who was going to give us some missions, but he sounded like a wise guy, like part of the whatever the equivalent of the mafia is around here? We are totally not doing that. I also don't know where Shemdrown's grave is because I'm bad at detective work. Unless it's actually on the map. Holy shit, it's on the map. I did not expect that. All right, sure. Let's teleport to Cabot House because we've already cleared the area between here and there, so we might as well just go up and look at the grave. I didn't even realize it was on the map. That's hilarious. How long has that been true? Apparently, Shianti put all the clues together, so way to go for her. Do appreciate it when your role-playing game actually, you know, lets you play the role without having to actually do the thinking for yourself. Because if you're playing, like, a level, I don't know, someone with, like, 20 intelligence, you, obviously, personally, probably don't have the equivalent of 20 intelligence. I mean... The rule books from like D&D say that intelligence 8 is about average, which means that's about 100 IQ. So to have like 20 int would be to like have, I don't know, 200 IQ? I don't even know if that's a valid IQ number. Oh, hello, Feral Ghoul Roamer. Hopefully you're not the guy I'm looking for, because now you're dead. Although you were feral, so you probably weren't going to talk to us anyway. Okay, so now we dig up the grave, for better or for worse. And we find the golden grasshopper. Is that how this goes? I thought we already had the golden grasshopper, but... Or gilded grasshopper. So if we read this, fear not. Though devil's iron makes this blade, only he who wields it can make it wicked. Okay. Oh, and then we have Shemdrown's sword.
Nice.
Targets take radiation damage. That's it? That's it? And there's a gold bar, which I guess we'll take, as well as a silver bar, copper bar. He just had a bunch of bars in here, but okay. Another copper bar. And his skull. No, I think I'm going to leave his skull alone, thanks. I'm going to take care of these reavers as soon as that one passes behind the gravestone and then comes out again. There we go. That's what I wanted. It's 95. Good. Oh, Roger Wicko's doing his best. These guys are full on melee. Unfortunately, Roger Wilco doesn't have any melee claws, but he is apparently doing his best. There we go. Okay. Well, they apparently didn't like me disturbing the grave, which is fair. So I guess it's on up to Sanctuary then, right? Because we're done. That's pretty hilarious. That was kind of the cap. The mission is a freaking melee legendary weapon. Okay, so that's not a thing we do. That's broken. That's broken. That we could do. I mean, we could do these two, but this is really just feels like filler. I don't think it's going anywhere. We can do the safe house, but where does that... Oh, there's a dead drop. Well, it's right here. I mean, it's going to point us towards somewhere way far away. But we are coming up to the end of this episode, so might as well at least pick it up and see where it points us to. So what's the destination for this? Clear hostiles at Wicked Shipping Fleet Lockup. Isn't that actually pretty close to Sanctuary? It is, actually. It's like right next to Abernathy Farm. So okay, might as well do it. It's probably not going to do much for us, but... It'll at least give us a little bit of experience. How close are we to leveling up? Okay. Yeah, we walked down to it. we might actually get level 77, and that'll give us at least one more rank in energy resistance. Okay, I'm for that. I think that's a good idea. Let's do it. Let's hike. We're gonna have to cross the bridge. This is how it's gonna work. Yeah, that's about right. We cross that one bridge and then we go across. That's good. We've already crossed this bridge before, which means there's not gonna be any bad guys around, so that's good. Okay, we can do that. So as far as the nuclear option goes, I mean, it is really... So the nuclear option in common parlance, I suppose, would be the way to put it. It is an idiom. It basically means a final option, as in option of last resort. No one ever wants to drop a nuclear bomb, the theory goes. I mean, this is basically what the mutual assured destruction theory is based off of, is that no one really wants to drop a nuclear bomb. So by doing it, it kind of indicates that you're down to your last straw. You have no other recourse. Something has gone horribly, horribly wrong, and there's nothing you can do. So you're breaking out your last option that's going to end the fighting, and that's your nuclear option. You're going to wipe them off the face of the earth, or whatever the equivalent would be. And in this case, it is probably going to be wiping them off the face of the earth. I mean, I don't see what other real options we have against the Institute. The Institute is full of bad guys. I mean, they're basically an organized group of raiders. I would love to say that they're better than that, but they're really not. They say they're for the future of the Commonwealth, but how have they proved that? By taking out any of the leaders of anyone who tries to make the Commonwealth a better place. I mean, that's essentially what the Raiders are doing. The Raiders are an organized group, all right, but they're organized for their own benefit, not to everyone's benefit. And you might say that's true of everybody. Everyone's always out for their own benefit, but I don't think that's true. I think generally, you know, we try to do good for everybody. It doesn't always work, I'll admit that. And I realize it's a bit of hubris to say, no, we're working for the better good. I mean, better good is such a wide and varied term that it doesn't always work. Not everyone has the same idea of what better good actually is. And I realize I'm going for headshots here, but they're working, so I'm totally fine with just pulling these off as best I can. Oh, that one didn't work. That's okay. That worked. We down to our last guy? That was it? I don't know where the heck Roger Wilco went. You were useless during that fight, Roger. The Institute has basically... I mean, from all we've read, all we've seen, the Institute sends out synths and coursers, who I would guess would be just advanced synths, but I guess they could be human. I mean, at this point, I don't see much of a distinction between synth and human. There's no way to detect whether or not it's a synth or a human without, like, tearing them apart, which would prove fatal to a human and not necessarily fatal to a synth, depending on how it was done. But it could be fatal to the synth, too. So either way, they're basically an organic being who... is sentient, sapient, can reason and be reasoned with. I mean, assuming they're willing to talk to you, which is not always the case. But, you know, if they are willing to talk to you, then at least, you know, they're reasonable. And, I don't know, they try to set up their own structures. I mean, the railroad is proof that the synths are basically... I mean, I don't want to call them human because that might be insulting to them, but they're at least... sapient. They are sentient beings who deserve respect and proper attention paid to them. So, I mean, it's just... And the Institute just constructs them and uses them as fodder, basically. Essentially, it's slavery. which is obviously bad. Sunstute basically creates these sentient beings, knows they're sentient, but sends them out to be fodder anyway. Then when the Commonwealth tries to rebuild, I mean, the reason why the Commonwealth is still this crappy 200 years later is partially the Institute's fault. Now, granted, it's not totally all the Institute's fault. It's also the Brotherhood of Steel. It's also the Enclave. Places like that like to keep technology and abilities to themselves and not share it with the rest of the world. If they had just, they would just share these things, the United States would have been built over, like, built, or built back up, rather, two times over by now. At least. I mean, there's also a possibility that war would have broken out all over again. What I'd really be interested in seeing is a Fallout game taking place not in America. So far, all the Fallout games taking place in America. And that's fair because all of it kind of goes to the 50s nostalgia. But I'd be really curious to see what's happening in, say, Australia. Is it as bad as Mad Max? I would guess not. But I don't know. What about South America? What about, you know, England? What about, I don't know, the Middle East? What, I mean, how does the apocalypse affect different parts of the world? We know pretty much how it affected America very, very, very badly. But how did it affect the rest of the world? Are they built up? Are they looking at America and going, that's a cesspool, don't go near it? I mean, that's totally fair. There's a lot of infighting around here, but you'd think also that, I don't know, that just the fact that maybe you need land, I mean, that's a possibility. I don't know. I'd be really curious to see if there's, like, anything left in the rest of the world. I mean, the fact that there are so many survivors in the Americas kind of indicates that there would be in, like, Korea or something. It'd be really interesting to see, like, China's view on this, because China was the other target. But maybe there was only a first strike and there wasn't a retaliatory strike. I mean, it seems unlikely with all the rhetoric going on. It seems more likely that there'd be a retaliatory strike. Well, you're not going to dig into your hole, little Morat. My guess is a bunch of other ones are going to pop out. Okay, well, we got one off. Couldn't grab the second one for whatever reason. I'm guessing he went. Yeah, he went down. Okay. Oh, man. Can't seem to hit these guys without vats. Okay, he dug in. Where'd he go? Oh, okay. Roger Walker got him. What the heck are you shooting at, man? Oh, there we go. The other one. Oh, nope, nope. I suppose I should have hit the crit that way. It would have happened. That's okay. Yeah, I know. He's still there. He's gonna pop out. Yep. There we go. Okay, so where the heck's this dead drop thing? I guess it isn't actually... Oh, it wasn't actually here. That's hilarious. I thought it was in here. How far away is it? Oh, much, much farther. Okay. Well, I'm gonna go ahead and end the episode here. It's been fun talking to you all. This has been Fallout 4. I'm PC Universe. You're PC Universe 2. I'll see you guys next time when we take care of whatever the heck the dead drop pointed us to, and then we start the nuclear option to take out the Institute and hopefully, maybe, possibly talk some sense into them before we blow them up, but it seems unlikely. Anyway, see you guys next time.